that God is peace. The Bible passage today is from Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 through 6. And if you'd like to follow on, it's found on page 691 of the Pew Bible. Again, I'll be reading from Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 through 6, page 691 of the Pew Bible. There shall come forth a rod from the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. His delight is in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by the sight of his eyes, nor decide by the hearing of his ears. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall slay the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt of his loins, and faithfulness the belt of his waist. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the young goat, the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them.
Join me in prayer. Lord, we thank you because we have this opportunity to worship you in song. Lord, as we continue to worship in songs, we continue to sing songs that tell the coming of your Son Jesus during this season. Lord God, please transport our hearts, our minds, both to reflecting on when it was that he first came and also when he will return to us. God, help us with that. You, Lord Jesus, we praise you and we thank you for being willing, majesty, and be with us here on earth so that you would one day be with us fully. You bring your kingdom fully on earth. Help us now, Lord, as we continue to sing. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's sing together.
Let us find our rest in thee, Israel's strength and consolation, home of all the earth, thou art, dear desire of every nation, joy of every longing heart. Born a child and yet a king, born to reign in us forever, now thy gracious kingdom bring, by thine own eternal Spirit, rule in all our hearts alone, by thine own to thy glorious throne.
me for a time of prayer. Lord, we thank you that you are peace. And through Jesus Christ, you bring us the peace that we must need, both peace with you and a baby born to die and return for our sin. And the peace that we have in you in all circumstances, all things in our lives, bring us in peace. God, I ask that in this season, both in you meeting our needs, Lord, as we bring before you our needs for our families, our friends, our work, our hopes, and our desires, even for this Christmas season, that you would speak your peace over us, that we would find our peace in your sovereign care, in your goodness to us, your provision for us, no matter what we may be experiencing or feeling. That today, Lord, as we hear your word preached, that you would remind us, maybe tell us for the first time, that your peace may not be what we think it is. It's something deeper. But the peace you offer us, Lord, is transcends all understanding in Jesus. It's something that is solid and stable, no matter how much the world may rock us. Help us, Lord, now to bring our concerns and our cares before you, to confess our sin before you, to bring our needs before you, and help prepare our hearts. God, as we continue to worship, both in the hearing of your word as well as momentarily, the giving of our gifts, of our provision, you have first provided to us. Help us to be thankful, even when things don't seem worthy of being thankful for. Because you, Lord God, are good. Remind us, Lord, deep down. Be with us, Lord, as we continue to hear from you. Speak to us, move our hearts. Today and the week to come. We praise you, Lord God, in your name we pray. Jesus Christ. Amen. The ushers may now come forward.
2 weeks ago. Thank you. So Catholics need the overflow though. They have so many
people. And that's fantastic.
Yeah.
To create a little more sensitivity in a room that has been built by the government for multi-use, you know, so
it's some Mormon template.
Yeah,
that's what I've been told. Yep.
Because, you know, we're supposed to serialize it. There's another word I think for it where
yes.
Services are supposed to so that when somebody comes in, it could be completely neutral or whatever. And
I don't like that at all. I don't think it should be neutral.
Yeah. I mean, it's funny. Space can be great for other things.
Yeah.
You know, if you don't want something, you need it. Churches that have space built like that for, you know, production purposes or whatever,
mm-hmm.
then they can actually manipulate it, not get lighting included, right?
Right?
So that the lighting is even more warm and all that stuff.
paved the way. Amen? Is it possible with God? Mary. I'm a virgin. It's okay. All right, let's do it. That's amazing. Because we serve a God that can do the impossible. He can save a wretched man like me. He can save you. Isn't that amazing? That's amazing. Hopefully that inspires you. You may be going through something right now. I don't know. Because what I want you to hear is not a health and wealth prosperity gospel that if you trust enough, God will throw in the zeros in your bank account. By a number and then zeros in the bank account. Maybe some of y'all already have some zeros in the bank account. Amen. I don't want you to hear that if you have more faith, God will bless you. What I'm saying is that God has already blessed you. Have faith. It's not just a transactional thing where God showed up on Sunday. I read the Bible. Gimme, gimme, gimme. No, it's saying that God will secure your place in heaven, not because that you are worthy, but because Him on the cross is worthy. You're already won. The path is there. Now we're just waiting for His return. The impossible can happen with God. The rich man came to Jesus and said, "How can I enter into heaven?" Jesus said, "Tell me, follow the Ten Commandments." God said, "Yeah, of course I do that. Give up everything and follow me." Can't do that. Jesus said, "It's easier for a camel to go by the needle than a rich man to enter the kingdom of God." The disciples said, "Well, how can anyone enter the kingdom of God?" What does he say? It's possible with God. I understand that some of you here today are inspired right now, but you're worried about your daughter, your son, who might not believe in Christ. You might be having some marriage issues, financial issues, career issues, and you don't see the path. I don't want to be flippant, like it doesn't matter. I don't want to like have more faith. I don't want to do that because it's not a prosperity thing. What I'm saying is God is doing something though. What I'm saying is that you might be at the waters if you haven't departed yet. What I'm saying is God is good. He can use a virgin to bring the kingdom of the world, and He can use you to transform it. God is doing it, and God is doing something too. I know it's hard sometimes to put your faith in the Lord. Because God doesn't reveal all the plans for us, does He? He doesn't tell you, hey, get this job, get this assignment. He doesn't say, study this part, not study that part, so you have more time. I at least convince him, sorry. But what He does say is that the growing light of Christ is entering the world, and He's going to come back. There's a part two. There's two to be continued. There's a sequel. So, Matt, you want to mind coming up? So what I'm going to leave you here today is that the peace of God doesn't mean you won't come to the waters. But the peace of God is saying there's a path. And the path is already been set. Mary was at the birth of Christ, obviously. She's also at the death of Christ. She believed. The Holy Spirit will overshadow you if you trust that. The Lord will be with you. Let us pray. Lord, Heavenly Father, thank you for your great peace in your servant Mary as an example of how she did. Now, Lord, the peace of God doesn't mean we won't face trials and temptations, Lord, that the storm won't be raging. But let us look to you. Oh, Heavenly Father, Lord God, the peace that surpasses all understanding, the peace of our King of Kings, Lord, the peace of God, settle on us today. Lord, if there's someone here that doesn't know that peace, maybe they're a young person who is struggling with their faith. Maybe there's someone here today that's struggling with their marriage. Maybe there's someone in here struggling with their addiction. Maybe there's someone in here, Lord God, that just needs to hear this right now. It is possible with our Father in heaven. Lord, maybe there's someone in here right now that already believes and they feel good and they feel great, Lord God, and this is an inspiring message, Lord God, but they need an outlet to serve. Lord, I pray for those individuals that they would have the strength and the courage to respond to your call, to come see me or another pastor and volunteer in this job. Lord, we need the workers because the harvest is mine. May, Lord God, you settle our soul with the worries of this world and remember that we're good. In Jesus Christ, amen. Matt, do we have a song? Thank you.
Let's sing.
Take Matt's hand, tell him to take a great job. Thank you.